Yo, it's Ross. We got ourselves a real special treat today. Something new. Something we haven't tried before in the orchard. And you can see over here, this is a muscadine grape. And these are some vines here that I planted out just this spring. We got them from, man, where did we get these? I guess from Ison's. Ison's a really nice cellar, nice nursery of muscadine grapes. And they have many varieties. And one of the varieties that they sell is something called Lane and Triumph. And the both of these, even in my Zone 7 climate, we'll see for sure this winter time, but the both of them will survive in Zone 7. And they have actually been proven. I have a couple friends who have reported data that the both of these varieties have survived negative 10 degrees Fahrenheit. So you can have a muscadine grape in a colder climate such as mine, even this far north as Pennsylvania. And when I look at my European grapes along the fence here, you can see this one's almost completely defoliated. The one in the middle looks really sad, and the one on the end is kind of just doing its own thing. But these are extremely difficult to grow, these grapes. And to get good quality grapes is also extremely difficult. Because they defoliate, because there's this disease, the black rot hits the grape and ruins the grape, mummifies the grape, it spreads very easily. If you don't train them correctly, you don't spray them, you don't remove some leaves and kind of get good airflow in here, you're just gonna have a huge issue in the Northeast in a humid area. Even with a very disease-resistant variety such as Mars, I'm still having an issue here on this property. So my advice, when we're gonna do this year, is we're gonna bag the grapes. We're gonna bag them so that the disease can't actually hit the grape. And we're gonna hope that the leaves don't defoliate enough so that the photosynthesis can still occur and pump out those carbohydrates into those grapes. So I think we'll be okay with the European grapes in the future, but it's a lot of work and it's annoying. And these muscadines here aren't affected by this disease. I mean, there is some, like, actually this is the European grape that's kind of just growing into the muscadine here. Let's get this out of the way. But you can see, I mean, these leaves are almost pristine. There's just nothing wrong with them. And they're used to this humidity. They're used to growing in this climate, and they actually taste really good. So it's like, why kind of worry about these European grapes when I can more rely on these muscadines? They're a very late grape, and this is really the time of the year in the fall that they'll ripen for you. So I want to pick this one here. Let's try it. This is kind of the first one ever. Whoa. Wow. Okay. Thick and sour skin. However, the inside's super, super sweet. And it's a slip skin. And I love the slip skins. They're kind of like, it's kind of like a Concord grape that I just ate. In that you bite into the Concord grape and the pulp slips away from the skin. And it's like you're eating two different fruits with two different flavors. And I love that. It's just like the best mouthfeel. Also, the flavor is off the charts. Way better than any table grape I've ever had other than Concord. And that was awesome. It's complex, sweet, sour. Oh man, I can't even really describe it. It really kind of was like a Concord grape. So for me, I think that's a really tasty grape, and I'm happy to grow them. I don't see why you wouldn't. There was no seed. They do produce differently. They produce in these smaller clusters than in a larger cluster of table grapes. But that was really good, guys. Some of them you need to get pollinated, so keep an eye out for that. Really read into this. And Ison's will describe this to you really well if you go on their websites, other website. Everything will be on the, all the information will be there. And I hope these will survive, because this is just gonna be a wonderful, wonderful thing that people can use and rely on in the future for a reliable crop of grapes. Yeah, they'll ripen in the fall and late in the fall, but that's not a bad thing. You know, there's not always so much abundance in the fall. I mean, there should be more abundance this year, but definitely the European grapes, you know, when these things fail, and they ripen also almost 2 months earlier. So you're getting a nice wide crop harvest here of grapes. You're getting, believe it or not, in July, you get the gooseberries. I have some gooseberries over here, which are very similar to grapes. And then you get the Europeans and sometime in August. And then now it seems like in October, you get the muscadine. So you're getting pretty much grapes all season as a backyard grower if you do it like this. All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed this one. We'll see you soon. Check out the blog, figboss.com. Check us out on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. We'll see you all soon. Take care, guys.